Welcome to this episode of Hidden History. In this episode, we will discuss the Chronovisor devised by Father Pellegrino Anetti, which is apparently stored in the Apostolic Archive, formerly known as the Vatican Secret Archive in central Italy. The Chronovisor is a device that was apparently constructed on the 7th of October 1954 by the Benedictine monk and Roman Catholic priest called Father Pellegrino Anetti and 12 scientists from Italy and locations around Europe. The Italian physicist called Enrico Fermi and the German space architect called Werner von Braun were two of the 12 scientists who helped to construct the Chronovisor. The Chronovisor was developed to function like a temporal observer mechanism that was able to see into the past. Father Pellegrino Anetti claimed he could observe the past with the Tempus Machaecina, or time machine, which he had supposedly invented. However, the existence of the Chronovisor has never been proven or verified. In a book called Father Anetti's Chronovisor, The Creation and Disappearance of the World's First Time Machine, that was written on the 2nd of March, year 2000, by Peter Krasser, extensive details are presented concerning the Chronovisor of Father Pellegrino Anetti. Further information about the Chronovisor is presented in a book called The Mystery of the Vatican that was published on the 6th of February 2002 by Father Francois Brun, who was a close friend of Father Pellegrino Anetti and truly believed the Chronovisor to be an authentic time machine. Father Pellegrino Anetti apparently helped build the Chronovisor and was a trained Benedictine monk from the Order of Saint Benedict, who was a polymath and Catholic exorcist. Anetti kept the device concealed from other monks and Roman Catholic priests until April 1962, when he confided in the French Roman Catholic priest known as Father Francois Brun and told him that 12 scientists constructed the Chronovisor, two of which were Enrico Fermi and Werner von Braun, had been involved with developing the Chronovisor. The Chronovisor was made of cathode rays, antennae and metals such as aluminium and copper that received sound and photonic signals on all wavelengths. Effectively, the Chronovisor was used to allow a team of scientists to document events from the past, including the crucifixion of Jesus Christ, the Italian dictator Mussolini, and the French Emperor Napoleon I. Additionally, scenes from the Roman Empire were observed. The actual time machine was therefore utilized to validate the teachings of Jesus Christ and the Holy Bible, simply by providing a direct look into the past events on planet Earth during the Roman Empire. The actual existence of the Chronovisor was detailed in the book called The New Mystery of the Vatican. In the book, Bruns explains how when he met Father Anetti on a boat ride across the Grand Canal in Venice in northeastern Italy on the 18th of September 1962, the Chronovisor was mentioned to him. Like Father Bruns and Father Anetti was well versed in the history of classical languages, which made for natural conversation. But soon Anetti directed their conversations towards Western science. In the quest to confirm the actual events of the Holy Bible, Father Anetti claimed that he had access to the truth via his Chronovisor. So where did the concept of this temporal observation device originate from? The Chronovisor was not actually a time machine that could transport humans into the past, but more a viewable portal into the past, which showed historical events on planet Earth, and could therefore be used to reveal the truth about the Bible, especially in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John in the New Testament. Functioning like a kind of television which caught photonic waves from the classical world of the Roman Empire that had been floating in space-time, and Father Anetti claimed he observed incredible things. Father Anetti said the Chronovisor had several antennae, three of which were made of metals such as aluminium and copper, and picked up sound and photonic waves across their entire respective spectrums. Father Pellegrino Anetti alleged that he and his colleagues had taken a peek into some of the most important events in the Bible using the Chronovisor. On the 2nd of May 1972, a publication that was produced in the cityscape of Milan in northern Italy called La Domenica della Corriere, the Sunday Courier, published an article titled "A Machine That Photographs the Past Has Finally Been Invented," which was shown to the Italian people. The magazine article claimed it had photographs from Roman legions to the crucifying of Yeshua ben Yosef, or Jesus Christ. Also, the witnessing of the Last Supper, in which Father Anetti kept the photograph of this event from the Holy Bible for himself as a kind of souvenir. Father Pellegrino Anetti passed away in June 1994 and persistently claimed that the Chronovisor was concealed by the Vatican Apostolic Archive, that was formerly called the Vatican Secret Archive, to safeguard it from ending up with subversive individuals. The designated Romana Curia, or higher court place of the Roman Catholic Church and the Vatican City State, stated on the 15th of December 1988 that anyone using an instrument of such characteristics would be excommunicated. The Vatican Apostolic Archive, that was formerly called the Vatican Secret Archive, is very well known for holding vast amounts of concealed knowledge to our past. Why does the Roman Catholic Church and the Vatican hide this information? Why do they have a Vatican Advanced Technology Telescope? The ornate Vatican Apostolic Library is a premises of the Holy See located in the Vatican City State that was formally established in 1475 at the end of the early medieval period, or the Dark Ages. The austere-looking Vatican Apostolic Library is a researcher's location for history, jurisprudence, philosophy, science, and theology. It is very hard to get public access into the Vatican Apostolic Library, and such a location would probably be too much for most individuals to handle, as a lot of the documents in that premises defy much of what has been taught by Western science. Would it be possible to actually construct a temporal device like the Chronovisor? When Father Pellegrino Anetti claimed to have created the time machine, concepts such as quantum lensing and precise electromagnetic-based events captured techniques were of huge interest to American scholarism and European polymaths. However, in Western science, this idea of the Chronovisor completely defies and changes how we have been taught to perceive this reality, and therefore cannot be confirmed to exist. Obviously, there is no corporeal evidence that would be able to confirm the existence of the chronovisor, and the inconsistencies in the claims have contributed to the doubts of its authenticity. But if the Roman Catholic Church and the Vatican City State wanted to keep it concealed so the invention could be safeguarded from the public domain, how would anyone therefore know? Most individuals do not realise that when Project Stargate was formed by the Defence Intelligence Agency, or DIA, it was directly connected with the chronovisor of Father Pellegrino Anetti. The incredible Stargate project was a remote viewing unit of the US Army established in 1978 at the installation of the US Army called Fort George in Maryland in the mid-Atlantic region of the United States of America by the Defense Intelligence Agency, the Army Research Institute of the US Army, and the SRI International from Stanford University in Western California. Perhaps we will never know the complete truth about the chronovisor of Father Pellegrino Anetti, but from the research that has been done, I can most definitely say this certainly existed. But would anyone care if the chronovisor was authentic? Would anyone even believe it could be? As the Vatican Apostolic Archive is consistently kept closed, the chronovisor still caused speculation today. And if this kind of occult technology is authentic, it could help actually save humans from the challenges we are facing today. Additionally, the chronovisor might end up causing much controversy for the beliefs of Western science and religions. Thank you for watching this episode of Hidden History. Please subscribe if you haven't already, or consider becoming a member to help this channel grow. Thanks for watching, everyone, and I'll see you soon.